Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, we will be talking about how to write result section of an article. Writing result section of an article have two ways for representation. One way is figures and second way is tables. If you are able to make good figures and you have good tables, and if you will be able to make good explanation of these figures and tables, so indirectly you can write your results section efficiently. So in order to further understand figures and tables, we should understand usually how the arrangement of result sections goes in any published article or manuscript. So in the step one, make all the figures and tables of your experiments. So this simple statement means you can make all the figures and tables of your experiment. Let's suppose your experiment have three figures and two tables. So it means first you have to decide either how many number of figures and how many numbers of table you want to include as per the main part of your experiments. So we can, before we go the further details how we will explain the result section and how we will explain the table section, we can further understand how the expression of figures and the table goes in any published system. So we can see that figure format and explanation is important. So in order to further understand, I will explain one example of published article. Here is figure one. We can see that in this example, here are the letters A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Actually, these A, B, C, D are called panels. We can see this panel A, panel B, C, D. So actually one figure is composed of several panels. We can see that usually there are some journal which require these panel name should be in small letters, some journal require in capital letters. So you can make any figure that is editable, like you can make your figures in PPT section so that you can change these letter later on according to the requirement. So another important thing which should be keep in mind, that all the figure panels should be placed together which have the flow of information relevant to each other. Like in this example, we can see that from figure panel A to panel G, all have the phenotypic data, and from panel H to panel I, all have the phenotypic data that is presented in the form of graphs. So it means you can integrate all the information, like you have taken the real time figures and you can make your graphs and you can integrate them into the final one picture. So it means one overall figure is further composed of several panels. So another important thing which I am going to mention is the explanation of these figure panels, which would be called as figure legends. So you have to individually tell that what is A, what is B, what is C. Like you can explain on the left side there is wild type, on the right side there is a mutant, that name is DPS1. You can say in the panel B figure legend, you can say that on the left there is wild type panicle and the right there is mutant type panicle. You can say that the different length of panicle, like 2, 4, 7, 6, and you can explain similarly like HG. You have to give individual details of A to I. So next thing which we need to understand is the table format and explanation, because sometimes it is needed to represent the data in the table form. So in order to further understand the how we will go with the tables, you have to mention one table number and the table title. I have seen many manuscript in which usually table number and the table title is not given so much importance as much the main text of the manuscript. So it is must, you must keep an eye with these all the things. You can also check with all the format of text, like you can choose Times New Roman, and the 12 you can have a look at all the text data is aligned at the center. So you should have all the formatting with the same, like it should have the equal space. These are the minor things, but usually they are important for deciding either your paper should go and select it for peer review processes or not. So similarly to figures, table legends are also important. So here I think I should mention this thing that usually although tables are welcomed and figures are also welcomed, but personally I prefer more to represent the data in the form of figure as compared to tables, because usually it is easy to represent the data in figures and the graphs as compared to the table, because if readers have to get something information from the tables, he has to carefully look into your data and then find your main results. So if possible, try to represent your all results in the figure form as compared to tabular form. But until and unless it is mandatory, you can also give your data in the tables form. So in the first step, we have decided that we have chosen three figures and two tables. Then you need to arrange your all figures, like the figure 1, figure 2, figure 3. Similarly, like the table 1 and table 2 and table 3, like if you have, depending upon your condition. So then you have to arrange all these figures, and you can open one PPT file and make all the figures and the panel names, and you can make these all figures and table editable. Like if some reviewers and some editor ask some changes, you may change in your previous file. So you can, when you have arranged these all the data, now you can start to explain your results in the headings. So now you have to explain the overall results of your experiment in small headings. Like the first heading, it is usually important to select the heading title. Actually, the heading title, like the your heading 1 is the explanation of figure 1 or the table 1. So it is not mandatory to always keep figure first or the table first. It is up to you, or it is the requirement of your own experiment, either you want to place figure first or the table first. But whatever, your first heading should be the explanation of figure 1, and your second heading should be the explanation of figure 2 and the table 2. So in simple way, in your all the results section, you are going to explain that what have been represented in figure 1 and what has been represented in figure 2. That would be the flow of your headings. So in the step 5, now you can consider a layman and start explaining like the panel A, B, C, D and so on of figure 1. That would be your first heading. And at the end, when you have discussed your all panel like A to J, then you have to add one concluding line that overall what you get from the figure 1, and you can add one line conclusion. So that's the arrangement. That would be the arrangement of your further explanation of your results. In this way, you can understand that how you can arrange your experiment data and make the conclusion with logical arrangement. So here I want to add one note that don't start interpretation of your results. Only provide either positive, negative, or significant or non-significant result. Don't try to write why it is significant. Like, I mean, never give explanation that if your data is significant, why it becomes significant, why, which factors were involved, because these all the interpretation would be part of discussion, not the result section. So here I would show you one example in which one author has given its results. So we can see that here are the results section. We can see that this is the heading, and this is the explanation of all the panels, like the from figure 1 A to G, figure 1c to e, L to I, what he want to say in these figures. And here we can see that he has added one paragraph, and he has mentioned that the overall this figure is indicating the impairment role of DPS1 in anther and epidural. So one line is enough. So here you can also see that he has added good explanation of figure 1 in the form of legends. Like here he categorically categorized, like the what is he mentioned, that morphology of wild type plant and mutant type plant in A, like in the what he mentioned in the B, what he mentioned from the C to G, what he mentioned, like all the mention, and even he has mentioned the significance of data, like the which analysis, like of the statistics, and he also talked about the p-values. So as long as you will keep an eye on the minor things, your writing can be good. And in the next video I will be making how to improve the scientific writing. That's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.